Hi, this is Sean. In this video, I'm going to record a quick tutorial on how to stream your levels. So some of my students have gotten to the point where they're building really extensive levels with lots of geometry, and they've noticed a performance drop as the level loads too much into too many textures and too many pieces of geometry into the scene. So how can you optimize that? Well, you can do a process called streaming your levels, where you dynamically load in and remove and unload components or different levels as the player goes through. So how has this been done? Well, in some of the games I've played, there's definitely been level streaming where you trigger a door, and before that door has been triggered, anything after that door hasn't been loaded in. So that's one technique that I've seen. So that's sort of how I've set this tutorial up. So how do we do this? Well, we've got two level files, dmstream1 and dmstream2. So this is dmstream2. dmstream1, it looks like it has this in the file, but in actuality, when you play it, let's just fly over that wall here quickly. Nothing's there. So, and then when we do play it and we trigger the door, not only is the door triggered, but this level is triggered as well. Okay, so how do we load in the other level? It's pretty simple. You go to the content browser level tab. So Control Shift F to pull up the content browser, and here's the levels tab. So you can also access it under the view, level properties, and here's the levels tab right here, same thing. And so you can go and you can say level, add existing level. And so what I did was I said level DM stream 2. And when you load that in, let's do that again. If you need to remove a level, you can go under level, remove level from world. So I needed to do that just in order to remove the level I had added to this level so I could show it to you. Let's re-add it. Add existing level, stream 2. And then it asks you what type of streaming method. You can have a always loaded, or you could load it by distance as the character gets closer, always load levels, or you can load it using Kismet, which is what I'm going to do in this case. So as I clicked it, you could see it load in the background here. And you don't actually always have to see that too. You can sort of hide the level. And then you can go to Kismet, in which case I've got this trigger that opens the door. It's tied to a matinee, but I also want, when I touch that trigger, I want it to launch a level streaming, a level stream. So when I touch it, we will load that level, and the level's name is dm-stream2. If I type that in correctly, it loads. So one of the things that you might want to do as a final thing that I'll say about this before I show it and finish the video is that when you walk into the level, you can't unstream the level you're streaming from. So you could conceivably always start by streaming in a consistent area. Like basically, I've done this with other programming methods where you sort of load in, you create a shell which is pretty much empty, and then you just load in whatever level you need from that shell. But anyways, that's just it's neither here nor there. You can do whatever you want. So let's play this. We walk up to the door, the door opens, and there's our level. Great. So thanks so much for watching.